all you brainiacs. Today I am going to discuss the spinal gallant reflex, what it is, some of the issues that are related to it if it is still active, and then my son Jackson is going to demonstrate it. So a spinal gallant reflex is one of those reflexes we're all born with. We don't have to learn this, we don't have to think about it. Just something that is there, and it is to help with our development. As a baby is coming through the birth canal, the mother's contractions will hit them on their backs and the back and the sides, and when that happens, then the baby will start wiggling, doing this, and you've seen babies do that. And that's so that the infant can help through the birthing process. Now, once they're born, that reflex is still there. And what it's doing is to help with the hip development. So they're still doing this movement, and it will help with the rolling over and crawling and walking. Now, usually around 9 months, this reflex has been integrated and turned off, in a sense. But when it's not and it continues, then some of the issues that you'll see are late bedwetting, the fidgety child that can't sit still, struggles with focus and concentration, and a lot of the reason why they have that problem is that they're sitting in a chair and that reflex is being activated by their pants or by the chair itself, and so they're constantly moving, and that makes it difficult to concentrate anyway. But also auditory processing becomes an issue. So anyhow, there is research, much research on this. You can look it up on the web, and just put in spinal gallant and ADHD, spinal gallant and auditory processing, spinal gallant and bedwetting. I have a really a great research article, but I can't find it. Once I do, I will put it on the Facebook page so that you can look at the research. Anyhow, let's go ahead, and I'm going to have Jackson demonstrate an exercise called the Slow Angel that helps to turn this reflex off. So Jackson, come on over.
Hello, people watching this video.
Okay, turn the other direction. Okay, I'm gonna, first of all, before your child begins, you need to get an app for a metronome. And you wanna set it at 60 beats per minute. So it'll sound like this. To begin, we are going to do a six count slow angel. So it'll be six counts up, six counts down. Notice that Jackson will be coordinating the movements of his arms and his legs at the same time, and they will move continually throughout. So he won't be moving his arms while his legs aren't doing anything. They're already at as far as they can go. Anyway, you'll get it when you see it. Okay, ready, Jackson? Arms down by your sides.
I'm ready.
Feet together. Okay, ready, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Good job.
Thank you. And you're welcome.
So he just did two. What I'd like to see is 10 reps. 1, 2, etc. 10 of these done at least once per day. For a month, every single day, Since you're only doing one exercise, I would push it out 2 months, just to, you know, make sure that you're doing enough. You can do this more often. You could do it twice a day, three times a day. The program that my son went through, brain training program, we did it three times a day. So once you're done, once your child can manage six count, you're going to do it eight count. So that's a different speed. At four is when you'll turn your hands, four, down. After eight, do you do the eight count for maybe another couple weeks, or until when your child can master that, then pop it up to 16. And of course, eight would be in the middle, up to 16, eight, and down. Until you get up to 30, and that is very slow. It requires a person to stay attentive and focused on both their arms and their legs at the same time. And so that's where you start building that attending and focusing skill. But I have to say, after 2 weeks working with one of my students, she had been a bedwetter. And she, after 2 weeks, her mom was like, "Hey, does this exercise help with bedwetting? Because she's having dry nights. She's never had that before." And I have this experience. I made a YouTube about it on my Facebook page earlier in this year. You can look at that. Anyhow, another exercise that I like to do in also with the Slow Angel is the crisscross crawl. And Jackson's going to go and demonstrate that. And this you'll do, start out with 10 reps. If your child can do 10 reps, do 20 reps. If they can do that, do 30 reps. But this one is also very useful because it is really activating a lot of the nerve endings in that lower back region. Okay, so Jackson, are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
Okay. Ready, begin. One, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six. Very good. Thank you, Jackson.
You're welcome, and thank you.
So, do both of these exercises at least once a day. More is always good, especially before bed. That would be a great time. And anyway, I wish you well. I hope that we explained and demonstrated these well enough that your child will benefit. And till next time, we'll have many more stories to share. Thank you.